Hello, welcome to this Touch Design tutorial. Today we're going to learn how to create a video transistor. So if I press the control key, or the alt key, sorry, it will switch between videos in a smooth way. So I'm going to show you how to create that. And yeah, let's get started. So just choose five videos randomly. And first thing we're gonna add is a switch inside the top node parameters, and we connect all five inside here, and we're gonna create a keyboard in, which is gonna be the key we are pressing when the video changes. So for me, I'm gonna use control, you can use shift, you can use alt, whatever. Alt action. You can use a count. That's the main tool here. Just go to the count page, set it to loop min max, and set the limit to 4, because we are starting at 0 in the switch. It's not starting at 1, so that's why we have to count 1 less each time. So just copy that, use that value inside switch, so click on here and click on there, and then drag it inside here. So now when I press alt, we're switching between the five videos. Very well, so that's the simplest way you can connect five videos together. If you need to export that, you can add a movie file in, movie file out, etc. The version I wanted to show you is a little bit more sophisticated, because it allows us to reduce the opacity of each video smoothly for each transition. So for that, we are gonna use a slightly different approach. We're gonna add a math, and we're gonna add 1 to it, and this math will connect it to 5 other math, just like that. Just copy and paste, and first one is going to be -1, the second is going to be -2, third is going to be -3, and fourth is going to be -4, and fifth gonna be -5. So now that we have this, we have, as you can see, a 0 appearing each for each time. I mean, that is cycling around basically. So we're gonna use that 0. So we're gonna add a logic, and that logic will give us something whenever the value is outside bounds. So right now it's 0 and 1, so it's also gonna say something when it's at 1, so we need it to be at 0.1. that way it will give us a value when it reaches 0 each time. So copy and paste that and connect the values here. Oops, just gonna do some reordering really quickly, and then all we need to do is pretty simple. We just need to add a filter. So the filter is gonna filter the data so that it goes smoothly. We can adjust the parameters slightly. It goes, yeah, that's the filter effect here. I'm just gonna leave it at 1 for now. Now for our videos here, we add a level for each. So actually, I'm just gonna, yeah. Oops. Just like that. And we want all of these to go inside one parameter, I mean one top viewer. PC is lagging a little bit. because of the size of my videos, I have to turn them off to show you. The comp, we're gonna use the over or the add operation, sorry. So now we have all our videos added up on each other, so it's not looking like anything. But if we now take all of that and place it here and drag the filter parameter to the brightness of each level, it's gonna lower the opacity for each video. You'll see. So just do that. And now when I change, when I press Alt, it does this effect. So yeah, I hope you find this useful. This can be used for like showing different creating a montage system, kind of. William Chap, already Electronaut is his name, already made a tutorial on how to make a video player, where it's a good system. I will link you to that tutorial, where you can use scripting. Well, it uses the folder, one of your folders of your computer, so you basically can put videos in that folder, and like the system will automatically make like a mix between all of these videos, so that can also become really useful. Anyway, I hope you liked this tutorial. Feel free to share any thoughts, and as always, have a good day.